Hello everyone, I hope you all are fit and fine at home. Let's start with another topic of general knowledge for class 7. This is your book of general knowledge for class 7. Today we are going to start with another topic, Indian handicraft, lesson number 14. Indian handicraft is an art of making crafts by hand in India is called Indian handicrafts in ancient India. There are 25 unique handicrafts and the geographical indicators of India. Indian states reflect the diverse history and religion. The crafts of each state in India reflect the different culture and tradition. These traditions form of handicraft is found in the state of Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Gujarat and almost all the states in India. Kalamkari is a type of hand painted or block printed cotton textile produced in Isfahan. Isfahan is a place in Iran. Isfahan is a province in Iran. It is famous for Persian-Indian handmade items. Kalamkari name originated in the Persian, which is derived from the word kalam means pen and kari means craftsmanship, meaning drawing with the pen. This form of art mainly produced in the states of Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. Only natural dyes are used in kalamkari and it involves 23 slips. As an art form, it found its peak in the wealthy Golconda Sultanate in Hyderabad in the Middle Ages. The Mughals who patronized this craft in the Coromandel and the Golconda province. It is a method of painting with natural dyes on cotton or silk fabric with the bamboo pen or kalam. Natural colors are prepared by mixing parts of the plants like roots, leaves and stem along with the mineral salt, iron, tin and copper. Let's discuss about another type of art. Bandhani art is a type of tie-dye textile decorated by plucking the cloth with the fingernails into many tiny bindings that form a finger-motif design. The term bandhani is derived from the Sanskrit verbal root bandhan, to bind or tie. Today, most bandhani market centers are situated in Gujarat, Rajasthan, Sindh, Punjab region and in Tamil Nadu. Earliest evidence of bandhani dates back to the Indus Valley civilization, where dyeing was done as early as 4000 BC. The earliest examples of the most pervasive type of bandhani dots can be seen in the 6th century paintings depicting the life of Buddha found on the wall of cave 1 at Ajanta. Bandhes sari, which is also known as bandhani sari, is specially found in Gujarat and Rajasthan. Let's discuss about another form of art, chikankari. Chikankari embroidery is a traditional embroidery style from Lucknow, India. It begin as a type of white-on-white embroidery. Chikankari is a delicate and artfully done hand embroidery on a variety of textile fabric like muslin, silk, chiffon, net, etc. White thread is embroidered on cool pastel shades of light muslin and cotton garments. Lucknow is the heart of chikankari industry today and the variety is known as Lucknowi chicken. It is appreciated all over the world for its amazing look. Terracotta means baked earth or clay. Terracotta is a term normally used for sculpture made in earthware and also for the various practical uses including vessels like flower pots, bricks, roofing tiles. In art history, terracotta is often used to describe the objects such as figurines not made on the potter's wheel. Indian sculpture made heavy use of terracotta from as early as the Indus Valley civilization. Chinese sculptures made great use of terracotta with and without glazing and color. From a very early date, the famous terracotta army of Emperor Qin Shi Huang. In Indus Valley civilization, we found terracotta items such as Mother Goddess, Bearded Priest and the Toys of Terracotta. Let's discuss about another art form, Madhubani art. Madhubani art or Mithila painting is a style of Indian painting practiced in the Mithila region of Indian subcontinent. This painting is done with a variety of tools including fingers, brushes, nib pins and matchsticks, and using natural dyes and pigments. It is characterized by its eye-catching geometrical patterns. It is originated from the Madhubani district of the Mithila region of Bihar. This unique style of art was used by the women to decorate their house walls and doors in order to seek God's blessings in the form of prosperity and peace. Okay students, I hope you understood the topic. You are able to solve the exercises. I'll come with the